Blackstone Publishing presents The Polar Adventures of a Rich American Dame, A Life of Louise Arner Boyd by Joanna Kafarowski. This book is read by Kate Mulligan. For my parents, Pamela Elizabeth Maud Loeth Kafarowski, 1928 to 2010, shared with me the delights of reading and visiting libraries and bookshops, and introduced me to the magical worlds of Naughty, the Andrew Lang fairy books, and the famous five, Dreamer, Dancer, Singer, Kindred Spirit. Zygmunt Kafarowski, 1924 to 2006, encouraged me and showed me how to set my goals high and then achieve them through perseverance, a solid work ethic, and sheer bloody-mindedness. Risk taker, philosopher, perfectionist, family man. With all my love. Far north, hidden behind grim barriers of pack ice, are lands that hold one spellbound. Gigantic imaginary gates with hinges set in the horizon seem to guard these lands. Slowly, the gates swing open, and one enters another world where men are insignificant amid the awesome immensity of lonely mountains, fjords, and glaciers. Five times have the gates opened for me. May they do so many times again. Louise Arner Boyd. Author's note. Although this is a comprehensive biography, it is my hope that it provides a springboard for future researchers to uncover the mysteries that still need to be revealed about Miss Boyd's life. There is also scope for a scholarly investigation into her scientific contributions. There is so much still to learn, and she is a rewarding subject. The research I conducted for this biography revealed a treasure trove of letters, documents, and artifacts related to Miss Boyd that are scattered across the globe. It highlighted the fact that the majority of her precious Greenland photographs and her expedition journals and logbooks are missing. In addition, although I was able to interview many people who graciously shared their personal experiences of Miss Boyd, there are still many others with Boyd stories to tell. I should be grateful if anyone with knowledge of Louise Arner Boyd photographs, logbooks, artifacts, or letters not noted in this book, or anyone with stories to share, would contact me through the publisher. Prologue. A sheltered life can be a daring life as well, for all serious daring starts from within. Eudora Welty. She gripped the ship's railing tightly with both rough-gloved hands while gazing somberly into the sprawling darkness of the frozen night. Tall for a woman, broad-shouldered, wavy brown hair tucked under a snug cap framing a handsome face with piercing blue eyes, she could easily have been mistaken for one of the crew. Beneath her feet, the hobby juddered and jarred as it made its way through the icy waters of the Arctic Ocean. The air was a constant thrum of men's guttural voices, the clang of thick cables and ropes, the bursting swell of the ocean as the ship slammed through the seething waves, moving forward on its perilous mission. Though unaccustomed to life on board ship and only recently acquainted with northern waters, California native Louise Arner Boyd found herself profoundly moved and invigorated by the experience, and more than a little unsettled. Whether above or below deck, she was never alone. There were always experienced seamen keeping a watchful eye on the gently bred American socialite who had somehow become an integral part of one of the most desperate quests in polar history, the 1928 search for missing famed Norwegian explorer Roald Amundsen. She caught herself as the ship yawed abruptly to starboard. What was she thinking? Only a few weeks before, she had been dressed in a bejeweled gown, dining on lobster at Claridge's in London, England, and dancing the quick step at the Ritz. And yet here she was, wearing stiff leather boots and rough woolen trousers that itched like the dickens, standing unsteadily on the slippery bow of a ship sailing northward. There was so much for her to absorb, so much that the male crew members just took for granted. Louise spent hours poring over detailed nautical charts, checking the hobby's position with a sextant, and quizzing the officers, more than might be expected of a respectable society lady of a certain age. But if she was going to contribute and really make a difference to this expedition, then she had to learn, and quickly, too. As Hobby's hull rose and fell rhythmically, she mused to herself that this was not the trip to Greenland that she had originally intended. Who knew what winding, dreary path her life would have taken if the Amundsen tragedy had not intervened and disrupted her travel plans? As unlikely as it seemed, Miss Louise Arner Boyd of San Rafael, California, was never supposed to be discussing weighty matters with naval commanders on the high seas, recognized by all on board as one of the leaders of a daring rescue mission of international significance. During that summer of 1928, far above the frigid Arctic Circle, the weathered schooner Hobby, Louise, and the Norwegian crew, including Captain Christian Johannesson and Captain's mate Astrup Holm, were sailing north in search of one of the greatest explorers of all time. Renowned for his bold exploits, geographic contributions, and endless brushes with death, Roald Amundsen had inexplicably vanished on June 18th during an effort to rescue the Italian explorer Umberto Nobile, who had himself gone missing in the airship Italia on its return flight from the North Pole. A Norwegian journalist noted tersely in a local Oslo paper, "It's a terrible thought that the rescue of one explorer might end with the death of another." Louise's first trip north had been an idyllic pleasure cruise a few years earlier. She had sailed with some intrepid friends around the rugged coast of Spitsbergen, Norway, and farther north, close to elusive Franz Josef Land. It was the fulfillment of a childhood dream. During her earlier trip to Spitsbergen, she had been overcome by joy at her first sight of the Arctic Ocean. She was entranced by the deepening silence late at night that was broken only by the heaving and jostling of the massive icebergs, the harsh crispness of the cold air that seared the lungs. That sense of absolute oneness with the primal core of the world. It stirred her blood just to think of it. To be honest, it was also the thrill of the mighty polar bear hunt that attracted her. Like many adventurous women of her class, she craved the chase, the adrenaline-pumping rush that comes from sighting.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.